Top 7 James Bond Movies. Was the first James Bond movie released in 1962? Let's find out. Today we are going to look at the top 7 James Bond movies, so without any further ado, let's get right into the video. At number 7, Never Say Never Again, 1983. Sean Connery's second appearance as James Bond in an adaptation of Ian Fleming's novel Thunderball, Never Say Never Again has the exact same basic story as Thunderball, except with updated 1980s gadgetry and the original boisterous Bond that fans have grown to love. Helmed by Empire Strikes Back director Irvin Kershner, the movie was a fittingly explosive affair for Connery's second return to the role after Diamonds Are Forever in 1971, though it's not considered an official Bond movie because it wasn't produced by Eon. At number 6, No Time to Die, 2021. Daniel Craig's final outing as James Bond was released and was enthusiastically ranked as not only one of the best films of Craig's run as 007, but as one of the top 10 James Bond movies of all time by critics through Tomato Meter and Metacritic scores. With multiple reoccurring characters from Craig's previous movies in the franchise, such as Christopher Waltz take on Blofeld, and Jeffrey Wright's version of longtime Bond ally Felix Leiter, it proved to be an emotional send-off for one of the most popular Bond eras ever, staying true to the iteration's underlying goal to make Bond a more story-driven series. At number 5, Dr. No, 1962. The movie that started it all, Dr. No, was Sean Connery's first outing as James Bond, releasing in 1962, and though it was well before the bells and whistles that the franchise would become most commonly known for, all of the character's impeccable style was present in bucket loads. Though a big financial success, Dr. No's critical reaction was more of a mixed bag back in 1962, but it has evidently been reappraised as one of the series' best over the following decades, and is a typical entry in most top 10 James Bond movie lists for more than a nostalgia's sake alone, with longtime Bond franchise cinematographer Ted Moore establishing a distinct cinematic look for the literary character. At number 4, Casino Royale, 2006. Casino Royale redefined Bond as a more low-tech character study than previous iterations, but lost none of the elegance of its look. Judi Dench carried on as M from the Brosnan era to great success, establishing herself as a key presence within the franchise's overall history, with Eva Green's more complex role as 007's love interest beginning the erosion of the concept of a disposable so-called Bond girl. At number 3, Skyfall, 2012. Tasked with reigniting interest in Craig's run as James Bond after Quantum of Solace underperformed with critics and audiences, as well as providing a story that fittingly celebrated the 50th anniversary of the franchise, director Sam Mendes managed to satisfy an overwhelmingly majority of critics and 007 fans with Skyfall. Great performances from Daniel Craig and Judi Dench coupled with Roger Deakins's gorgeous cinematography make it a high-caliber experience, but the plot is commendable as well for finding ways to add dimension to Bond's often oversimplified character history. At number 2, From Russia with Love, 1963. Still very much in the stripped-down era of Bond, Connery's second movie as 007 may be the least ostentatious Bond movie ever, but the simplicity highlights some of its more Hitchcockian qualities, an interesting feature when considering Hitchcock's reported interest in the project. These relatively aesthetic sensibilities, coupled with Robert Shaw's intimidating bad guy and the first appearance of Desmond Llewellyn as Q, have helped From Russia with Love to remain essential viewing for fans, and a mainstay on top of top 10 Bond movie lists for decades. And finally, at number 1, Goldfinger, 1964. Still to this day, the epitome of what the vast majority of people would think of being a Bond movie, Goldfinger delivered so many of the greatest hallmarks for the franchise. Standouts include, of course, the all-time great Bond movie henchman Oddjob and his killer hat, as well as the debut of Bond's signature vehicle, the Aston Martin DB5, which would stick with the character up to and including Daniel Craig's era of the character. It's quite easy to see why the movie remains the quintessential 007 experience in the eyes of many critical opinions. The name Goldfinger has come synonymous with the spy genre. Goldfinger set the tone for almost every action spy movie that followed it. Well guys, that's it for today. Let us know if you guys agree with the list we have created or what different movies you would have wanted on the list yourself. We hope you liked the video. Thank you so much for watching until the end, and as always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon. Till then, see you guys next time.